Hi, welcome to my new video. This time I wanted to show you how I made this watercolor and pencil illustration. This is along the lines of what I usually do with my art, but I took a little bit different approach than usual with this picture. And I will explain what I mean later in the video. But first I want to explain a little bit what this is. I was asked by the publisher of my two books, so Tokyo Storyfronts and Tokyo at Night, to do a new postcard illustration. So this illustration will be used for postcards and other promotional materials like posters and leaflets to promote my two books in the coming spring season. And I was asked to combine the themes of my books, so the old retro stores and the night of Tokyo, with the spring season in Japan, so with the sakura, so with hanami, to make it more like an event than just trying to sell the copies of the book. Last year I did a similar picture with me and Kana walking around and enjoying the cherry blossoms. But this time I also wanted to connect this picture with my Tokyo at Night book, so I decided to picture a night sakura, so yozakura, with me and Kana enjoying a drink in front of an old retro sake store. And this would be really easy actually to do for me because I drew a lot of old stores. I still have a lot of reference photos that I haven't used yet. I have some materials, I have some photos that I could use just to paint the scene directly. We could actually go with Kana and stage something similar, make some photos, and it would be really easy to do this illustration from a photo reference. But because of my recent resolution to focus on a story of the piece before the visual part and to try to make it deeper without using any direct photo reference, not just paint it as fast and efficient as I can, but to put more thought into the process before I start painting the final thing. So this time I also thought, okay, I will use this commission as an opportunity to practice this, because a picture like this is perfect. I should be able to paint this without any reference or with limited reference because what I did with my previous two books. So I had some elements of an old sake store in my head because I saw shops like this when we were looking for interesting stores for the Tokyo Storyfronts book. And we saw some of those when we were looking for places for the Tokyo at Night book, but I ended up not using them. And what's more, recently we discovered a shop like this with Kana on one of our walks. And it was kind of interesting because you could actually buy glasses of various kinds of Japanese sake there. So you didn't have to buy a whole bottle to test a lot of interesting tastes. And we'll probably go there again. This is probably where this idea for the illustration came from in the first place. I wanted to picture what a shop like this would look like in the night, in the sakura season, with some chairs and tables outside open till the late night, with a nice lantern in the front just lighting everything up. And I also knew that the trees themselves would be lit up, so with some paper lanterns. I tried to imagine how a sakura at night would look like based on what I knew from when we were still living in Waseda, because there was a river there with cherry trees on both of the banks and people would just walk there and stroll in the sakura season, just enjoying the trees in the day and in night, and they were actually lit up like this. So I had the information in my head, I just had to use it properly to make a story, to make an illustration that seemed like a part of a story, and I tried it here. Of course, I couldn't just paint a shop like front of a shop and we just standing there or sitting there and having the sakura on left or right or whatever, because the picture would not work. So I thought a lot about this. I did some sketches. I did the rough sketches that you were able to see in the beginning of this video, and I figured out that if it would be just a corner of the store visible, I could make the tree in the back, so we would be sitting with Kana on a street corner, and with this I could have this interesting perspective, also showing the night city in the back, so tying it to the Tokyo at Night thing. and it would be perfect. So this is how I decided the overall look of the picture, what I want to have in it. And then from there in Procreate digitally, I tried to develop all the details that were needed. So add the necessary details to the shop to make it real, add the necessary details to us, to me and Kana, to make us real, and to the tree, to make every part of the picture to help to tell the story that I wanted to show here. I put a lot more thought into this concept stage of making this picture than I usually would with a scene like this, and I think it shows, and I'm actually happy how it turned out because of that. And when I had the contents down and the story down, I sent the digital sketch to my publisher to check if it was okay. It was, so I was able to move to actually painting and drawing this on paper. And here also I used a different approach to what I would usually do to make this illustration happen. And to explain this, I will use two terms: high impact watercoloring and low impact watercoloring. And let me just explain what I mean here. High impact watercoloring is when each wash or brush stroke that you do to finish your watercolor painting has a high impact on how the finished piece will look like. So for example, if you look on YouTube for some artists that do watercolors and they do those really brave, large washes of color that cover almost the whole paper, and then from there they look for the shapes of the things that they want to paint, and it's all very fluid and dynamic. This is high impact. Each stroke that they do has a high impact on what the finished piece will look like. And I was using this method a lot in my painting so far. I did this a lot with my storefronts and with my night scenes. Each stroke that I did had to be like finished and perfect. This was just how this part of the picture will look like. But low impact watercolor painting involves a lot of really small and watered down washes that themselves don't have a big impact on how the picture will look like in the end, but bit by bit, layer by layer, wash by wash, the picture is built up with small steps layering not so huge and brave washes, but small changes with each brush stroke, which makes for a longer process that is probably a bit more easy to control and deliberate, though probably a little bit less exciting and full of energy. And as I said, I would paint more with the high impact style. So if I had a difficult color passage, I would try to do it in one go, just painting a difficult color gradient, mixing the colors as I went and trying to get everything right in my first wash. So I didn't have to layer the paint so much. I believed that for most of paintings that I did, this approach was the best and produced the pictures that had the greatest impact they could. And I still, I think, was right for that, because I was using the high impact watercolor painting technique. I got some really stunning watercolor effects in some of my paintings, and I'm happy I did that. But for a picture like this one, where I want the focus to be on the story, on the content, on the atmosphere of the place, and not on the fact that, oh wow, how did he get watercolors to do this aspect of watercolor painting? So here I thought that the low impact watercolor painting that allows for more control and more deliberate painting would be more beneficial for me, for the thing that I had in my head, for the image that I had. I think I was right, it went well. I think I painted really close to what I wanted for this picture. I added details layer by layer using more watered down paint that I would usually do at all. I painted even the sky in few layers, and I'm actually pleased with the result. It looks more natural, it looks more interesting and deep than what I would get if I would just be painting as usual, so trying to use as few layers as possible. Okay, so here is the finished picture. I like it a lot, and I actually had a lot of fun doing this because this is low impact painting, so each stroke is not so stressful because you can just spoil the whole thing with the next brush stroke you do. Okay, that's it for this video. Excuse my rambling in this one. I hope you liked it. As always, feel free to share, comment and subscribe, and you can also support me on Patreon. See you in the next one. Bye!